Welcome back to Living 808. It is PTSD Awareness Month. This is such an important topic. And today I have Danny Mayberry here with me, a combat veteran who spent the last year and a half traveling as part of exposure therapy for PTSD. Aloha, Danny.
Hey, Kelly, how are you doing?
So good and so glad to have you back, not only back here in Hawaii, but back on the show as well. So if you folks remember, Danny and I actually did the Spartan race together.
Oh my gosh, it was so much fun.
It was a blast. Teamwork makes the dream work. You guys were helping to hoist me up over things. And so that was a really great time. And that was all to promote your podcast, 1 Mile, 1 Veteran. And for those that don't know, before we talk about what you've been up to the last year, remind us what your program is all about.
So 1 Mile, 1 Veteran podcast is a mental health podcast focused on helping veterans overcome various challenges within their life through promoting physical well-being, mental well-being, family relational. We interview inspirational guests, share resources and personal experiences that have helped us. And we encourage our listeners to walk 1 mile while listening to the episode. So each episode is edited to about 18 to 24 minutes. And that's the average time it takes to walk 1 mile, because we know that getting outside, getting exposed to the light, and doing that physical activity is enough to start overcoming feelings of depression, raise our endorphins, and really get us going on to the next thing.
And you mentioned physical well-being. I have to say, some people might not recognize you. You look incredible. How much weight have you lost?
Almost 60 pounds to date.
Awesome. Okay, so share a bit about that journey, but mainly share about what you've been up to the past year.
Yeah, so for the last year and a half, my wife and I sold our home so that we could promote the podcast and travel as much as we possibly could, getting the word out, because we know that this isn't just a national issue, but a worldwide issue. And I started actually putting a lot of the lessons learned through the podcast into my daily activities. And within 6 months, I was already 30 pounds down.
Wow.
And it was quite a game changer, not just like physically of how I feel and how I look, but also my mental cognition started coming back. I was able to focus more. I was able to put myself in more austere environments. I mean, we went to France for the Normandy Remembrance, and then a month later we were in Greece, rock climbing. We went to Egypt and did some dune bashing, and then finally spent the winter in Canada, all while interviewing veterans along the way and me continuing to put these things into practice so that our listeners can know they work.
Right. And I feel like, I mean, all of that sounds so much fun, but it is really stressful. And as someone that has suffered with PTSD and depression, how did the travels and the whole year affect you?
So when we had started off, it was really rocky, really rough going. I had a lot of tools in my bag and I just wasn't using them. Mm-hmm. I wasn't taking charge of my day from the very beginning. I was allowing myself to lay in bed when I was feeling depressed. It was really hard to get going. I started seeing photos of myself traveling the world with my wife, and I was really unhappy with, one, what I saw, and two, when we would come home, just how I felt. And so when we were in Greece, I kind of resolved to say, I'm going to do these every single day. And it literally changed my life to the point where I started taking on one of the biggest challenges that I have, which is my fear of heights.
Yeah. And we're gonna be doing something to help bash that as well. But I mean, I know that you've improved along the way and really learned these really great tools. So what tips do you have to share with our viewers for folks to improve their physical, but also especially mental health?
Absolutely. The first one I would say is establish some form of routine, having something that you do every day with absolute commitment. So mine just started off with, I'm going to walk 1 mile a day. And that was part of my routine, and it helped bring me a little bit of clarity. And then of course I expanded upon my morning routine to include good reading. I sit there and question, like, what are my intentions for today? I meditate and then I get moving. And then the next thing is start small. I started with 1 mile. Like, people don't believe that I lost 60 pounds by walking 1 mile a day. And I was like, that's where it started. What it led me to was life changing. But like, I wouldn't have had the life change without the small start. So pick one small thing to change about your day to make it a better day for you. And then the third tip is invite others into your journey. Mm-hmm. People that you trust, that you know will help motivate you and keep you going. And when the days get tough, you have somebody that you can talk to in a non-judgmental form to say, hey, I'm not feeling motivated. And maybe they'll get out and walk that mile with you.
I love that. All right, really great tips. And you mentioned, you know, conquering fears, right? And so you tried to tackle a really big one in Greece. I know it didn't go quite as planned. The video is up on YouTube if people want to watch it. I don't know if I should promote that. But you're actually challenging yourself again. Can you quickly tell us a bit about what that is?
Yeah, so I'm terrified of heights, but I was hoping that the tools that I was starting to put in place would help me overcome my fear of heights and that I could control any emotional reactions. Unfortunately, at about 75 feet in the air, I had an utter panic attack. And so in response to that, you know, came down the mountain and I was resolved to do it again a year later. And now we're approaching the year-long anniversary and I'm more practiced at my mental well-being. I'm in better physical shape. We've been training at places like High Climb. We got to go out there and prep for an upcoming challenge because we want to show people that you can overcome any fear and any obstacle that's in your way with enough preparation, enough training, and enough resolve. And thank you so much for agreeing to join us because we're trying to raise awareness and get our Instagram account to 10,000 followers. And if we're able to accomplish that, our Instagram account of 1 Mile 1 Veteran to 10,000 followers, we're going to go back and I'm going to climb another mountain out here in Hawaii.
Amazing. All right, so make sure you go ahead and follow along. Again, what's your Instagram handle?
1 Mile 1 Veteran.
Perfect. And of course, they have the link to the podcast there as well. Listen to the podcast, check out their Instagram, and get him back on that mountain again. I'm so proud of you. It's incredible to see not only how far you've come in your mental health journey, but how you're inspiring so many others to better themselves physically and mentally. So we're so proud of you, Danny.
Thank you so much, Kelly. It's such a pleasure. And I hope that we get to climb a mountain together.
I know. So that's the plan. We'll go together. So make sure you follow along. More when Living 808 returns. Stay with us.